Very good morning, students. I welcome you all, 12th standard commerce students, for this commerce online class. Let us now see the chapter 25, government schemes for entrepreneurial development. See the learning objectives of the lesson. India's efforts at promoting entrepreneurship, specific entrepreneurship schemes, steps in promoting an entrepreneurial venture, women entrepreneurial schemes, government of Tamil Nadu entrepreneurial schemes. So we'll be seeing about all this in this lesson detail. Government of India's support for innovation and entrepreneurship in India. The Government of India has undertaken several initiatives and instituted policy, that is set up policy measures to foster a culture of innovation and entrepreneurship in the country. So the Government of India has introduced many policies so that the foster of culture of innovation and entrepreneurship will be entering into the country. Job creation is a foremost challenge facing India. That is, unemployment problem is a very challengeable problem for India. India, however, has immense potential to innovate, raise entrepreneurs and create jobs for the benefit of the nation and also for the world. So in the recent years, a wide spectrum of new programs and opportunities to nurture innovation, that is to set up innovation, have been created by the Government of India across a number of sectors, namely agriculture, chemicals and fertilizers, finance, commerce and industry, communication and information technology, corporate affairs, culture, food processing, housing and urban poverty alleviation, and science and technology, etc. So India's efforts at promoting entrepreneurship and innovation. Let us see what are the efforts put forward by India in order to promote entrepreneurship and innovation. First one, Startup India. Through the Startup India initiative, Government of India promotes entrepreneurship by mentoring, nurturing and facilitating startups throughout their life cycle. Since its launch in January 2016, the initiative has successfully given a head start to numerous aspiring entrepreneurs. A fund of funds has been created to help startups gain access to funding. So it was a new policy started by the Government of India in order to promote more entrepreneurs in the country. So this scheme mentored, nurtured and facilitated the entrepreneurs to start up their business in India. It was launched in 2016 and has successfully given a head start to numerous aspiring entrepreneurs. A fund of funds scheme has been introduced to giving non-stop funds for the entrepreneurs. Next, Make in India. This scheme is designed to transform India into a global design and manufacturing hub. So this scheme was mainly designed to transform India into a global design and a manufacturing hub. I hope you know what is a hub, the meeting place where you have more manufacturing center. The Make in India initiative was launched in September 2014. It came as a powerful call to India citizens and business leaders and an invitation to potential partners and investors around the world to centralize information about opportunities in India's manufacturing centers. So this scheme is a powerful call given not only to the Indian citizen and business leader, and it was also an invitation for all the potential partners and investors around the world to come and have a or set up a manufacturing center in India. This has in turn helped to procure investments, foster innovation, develop skills, protect intellectual property, and build best-in-class manufacturing infrastructure. So this helped a lot for India, like procuring investment, foster, develop new innovation, develop skill, protect intellectual property, and build best-in-class manufacturing infrastructure. Third, AIM, Atal Innovation Mission. AIM is the Government of India's endeavor to promote a culture of innovation and entrepreneurship, and it serves as a platform for promotion of world-class innovation hub, grand challenges, startup business, and other self-employment activities, particularly in technology-driven areas. So this AIM is the Government of India's policy. It was promoted mainly for to culture of innovation and entrepreneurship, and it serves as a platform for the promotion of world-class innovation hubs, grand challenges, startup business, and other self-employment activities, especially in the technology-driven areas, the area where technology is not in existence. Next one, support to training and employment program for women, STEP. So STEP was launched by the Government of India's Ministry of Women and Child Development to train women who have access to formal skill training facilities, especially in rural India. So this was mainly set up by the Government of India in order to train the women who have access to formal skill training facilities, that way especially in rural India. The Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship and Niti Aayog recently readapted the guidelines of the 30-year-old initiative to adapt to present day needs. So they have redrafted this 30-year-old initiative to adapt to the present day needs. The program imparts skills in several sectors such as agriculture, horticulture, food processing, handlooms, traditional crafts like embroidery, travel and tourism, hospitality, and computer and IT services. Next, Jan Dhan Aadhar Mobile, that is JAM. JAM, for the first time, is a technological intervention that enables direct transfer of subsidies to intended beneficiaries and therefore eliminates all intermediaries and leakages in the system. So JAM, this was introduced by the Government of India for the first time, is a technological intervention that enables direct transfer of subsidy from the government to the beneficiary, and it eliminates all the intermediaries and the leakages in the system. Digital India. The Digital India Initiative has been launched to modernize the Indian economy to make all government services available electronically. The Digital India Initiative has been launched to modernize the Indian economy to make all government services available electronically. The initiative aims at transforming India into a digitally empowered society and knowledge economy with universal access to goods and services. So the initiative aims at transforming India into a digitally empowered society and knowledge economy with universal access to goods and services. Next, Stand Up India. So this was launched in 2015. It aims at enabling economic participation of women entrepreneurs, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, and share the benefit of Indian growth with the above mentioned categories. So it aims at enabling economic participation of women, SC and ST, and share the benefit of Indian growth. Towards this end, at least one woman and one individual from the SC or ST communities is granted loans between rupees 10 lakhs to rupees 1 crore to set up greenfield enterprises in manufacturing services or the trading sector. So what they do? At least one woman and one individual from SC or ST communities, loans have been sanctioned, which is arranged between the 10 lakh to 1 crore, mainly to set up greenfield enterprises in manufacturing services or the trading sector. Trade-related entrepreneurship assistance and development, TRED. So this scheme envisages to address the critical issues of access to credit among India's underprivileged women. So this scheme envisages was set up to address the critical issues of access to credit among India's underprivileged women. The TRED program enables credit availability to interested women through non-governmental organization. So it enables credit availability through the non-governmental organization to women, that is NGOs. As such, women can receive support of registered NGOs in both accessing loan facilities and receiving counseling and training opportunities to kickstart proposed enterprises in order to provide pathways for women to take up non-farm activities. So this was set up by the government in order to give a credit facility to the underprivileged women. So this program enables credit availability to the interested women through the NGO. So women can receive support of NGO both for accessing loan facilities and also for receiving counseling and training opportunities to kickstart the enterprises in order to provide a good pathway for women to take up the non-farm activities. Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, PMKVY, Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. This is a skill certification initiative which aims to train youth in industry relevant skills to enhance employment opportunities for livelihood creation and employability. So this is a skill certification initiative which was aimed to train the youth in industry relevant skills to enhance employment opportunity for those people for their livelihood creation and employability. National Skill Development Mission. This scheme was set up in July 2015. The mission aims at building synergies across the sectors in terms of skill training activities. With the vision to build a skilled India, it is designed to expedite decision making across the sectors to provide skills at scale without compromising on quality or speed. So this was set up in July 2015. So its main aim is to build synergy across the sector in terms of skill training activities. So with a vision, what is the vision? Skilled India. It is designed to expedite decision making across the sectors to provide skills at scale without compromising on quality or speed. Science for Equity Empowerment and Development, SEED. So SEED aims to provide opportunities to motivated scientists and field-level workers to undertake action-oriented, location-specific projects for socio-economic gain, particularly in the rural areas. So this seed aims to provide opportunities to motivated scientists and field-level workers to undertake action-oriented, location-specific projects for socio-economic gain. All this takes place in the mostly in the rural areas. Seed emphasizes equity in development so that the benefits of technology accrue to a vast section of the population, particularly the disadvantaged. Other specific entrepreneurship schemes. In order to support and strengthen the startup culture in India, the government has launched various schemes in the past few years. Next one, New Gen Innovation and Entrepreneurship Development Center, New Gen IEDC. New Gen IEDC provides a limited one-time non-recurring financial assistance to entrepreneurs up to 25 lakhs in the field of chemicals, technology hardware, healthcare and life sciences, aeronautics, aerospace and defense, agriculture, automotive, telecommunication and networking, computer vision, construction, design, non-renewable energy, renewable energy, green technology, fintech, Internet of Things, nanotechnology, social impact, food and beverages, pets and animals, textiles and apparel. So if you start any one of these business, then the government, that is New Gen IEDC, comes forward and sanction a loan up to 25 lakhs. Dairy Entrepreneurship Development Scheme. So Dairy Entrepreneurship Development Scheme aims at helping entrepreneurs in the field of agriculture, pets and animals and social impact to set up small dairy farms, and incentives are provided to cover the cost of the required equipment or establishment of the facility. So this scheme aims at helping the entrepreneur who is setting up industry in the field of agriculture, pets and animals, social impact to set up small dairy farms, and they also supply incentives to cover the cost required equipment or establishment of the facility. Next one, Single Point Registration Scheme, SPRS, a great scheme for micro and small enterprises, which provides an exemption from payment of earnest money deposit. Under the scheme, the tenders are issued free of cost. So a great scheme for micro and small enterprises, which provides an exemption from payment of earnest money deposit. Under the scheme, the tenders are issued free of cost. Next, Atal Incubation Center, AIC. The Government of India has set up the Atal Innovation Mission, AIM, at Niti Aayog in 2016. This has been set up to provide high-class incubation facilities across various parts of India in terms of capital equipment, operating facilities, along with sectoral expert for monitoring startups, especially in transport, manufacturing, health, energy, water, agriculture, and construction center. So it is also a helping scheme which was set up in 2016 to provide a high class incubation facilities across various parts of India. Reasons why women become entrepreneurs. Innovative thinking, role model to others, self-identity and social status, need for additional income, support of family members, education and qualification, self-fulfillment, new challenges, freedom to take own decision, employment generation, success stories of friends and relatives, government policies and procedures. Steps in promoting an entrepreneurial venture. The various steps involved in starting a venture have been highlighted. Selection of the product. An entrepreneur may select a product according to his aspiration, that is, according to his will, his capacity and motivation, after a thorough scrutiny of micro and macro environment of the business. So any entrepreneur, he has to do a thorough case study and select a product that he is going to produce. He may select a brand, new product, or may like to select imitation one, or may improve upon an existing product in terms of additional features like comfort, convenience, ease of operation, lower price, etc. An entrepreneur has to conduct economic viability of the project. So first duty is what? The entrepreneur has to select the product according to his aspiration, capacity and motivation. After that, he has to decide whether he is going to introduce a new product or he is going to do the imitation work of the existing product, or he is going to introduce some additional features like comfort, convenience, ease of operation, lower price, etc. An entrepreneur has to conduct always an economic viability of the project. Second step is selection of form of ownership. Entrepreneur has to choose the form of organization suitable and appropriate for his ventures, namely family ownership or partnership and private limited company. He has to choose what sort of organization he is going to follow. Either it is going to be a family ownership or a partnership or a private limited company. Family ownership and partnership forms of organization are suited for exercising unified control over the venture. Company form of organization may be preferred for pooling of more financial resources, managerial and technical skill and business experience for carrying on medium to large venture. If your business is small, then you can select either the family ownership or the partnership form of organization, and you need not require more number of resources. But if you take the company form of organization, it may be preferred for pooling of more financial resources, managerial and technical skills and business experience for carrying an medium to large venture. So family ownership and partnership is essential for small business, and company form of organization is essential for medium to large scale business. Third one, selection of site. So entrepreneur has to choose suitable plot for accommodating his venture. He has four options open to him for housing his venture. State Development Corporation like CIDCO, SIPCOT, MMDA, TNHP and Directorate of Industries may allot plot to entrepreneur. Entrepreneur can have a factory sheds constructed by State Industrial Development Agency. Entrepreneur can start ventures in the land developed by private developers. Entrepreneurs may buy private land and develop it for industrial use. Things may be considered in choosing the site, namely nearness to native place, incentives provided by the government, nearness to market, availability of labor and raw material in a particular area, infrastructure facilities. So you have made a decision what sort of company you are going to start. Next you have to select the site, in which place you are going to start your industry. So an entrepreneur can have a factory constructed by State Industrial Development Agency, or he can start his business developed by the private developers, or he may buy a private land and develop it for its industrial use. He can choose any one of the out of the four options. But while choosing that, he should keep various points in mind. What is that? The place he is choosing should be nearness to native place. It should be nearness to incentives provided by the government, nearness to market, availability of labor and raw materials in a particular area, infrastructure facilities. So you have to keep all these points in mind, and then he has to choose the site. Next, designing capital structure. Entrepreneur has to determine the source of finance for funding the venture. He may mobilize funds from his own saving, loan from friends and relatives, term loan from banks and financial institution. So he has made up his mind to produce a type of product. He has selected the area. Next, he is in need of money. So entrepreneur has to determine the source of finance, how he is going to get the source to start his business. So he may be using his own saving money, or he get the loan from a friends and relatives, or he may get the loans from the banks and other financial institutions. Next, acquisition of manufacturing know-how. Entrepreneur can acquire manufacturing know-how from government research laboratories, research and development divisions of industries, and individual consultants. Entrepreneur can acquire manufacturing know-how, how to manufacture, from the government research laboratories, research and development divisions of industries, and individual consultants. At times, main units may supply manufacturing know-how to entrepreneurs. Starting ancillary units or plant and machinery suppliers may provide this facility to entrepreneurs. At times, main units may supply manufacturing know-how to entrepreneurs. Starting from ancillary units or plant and machinery suppliers may provide this facility to entrepreneurs. Preparation of project report. Project report needs to be prepared according to the format prescribed in the loan application form of term lending institution. This report should cover aspects like sources of finance, technical know-how, sources of labor and raw material, market potential and profitability. So they have to, each entrepreneur, they have to make a report. That report is called as a project report, according to the form prescribed in the loan application of term lending in institution. This report should cover various aspects like source of finance, technical know-how, sources of labor and raw material, then market potential, and also the profitability. The project report should include the following. Technical feasibility, it should mention the following. Description of product specification, raw materials availability, manufacturing process, quality control measures, availability of water, power, transport and communication facility. So the project report, all these points should be there. What are the points? Description of the product, raw materials available, manufacturing process, quality control, availability of water, electricity, transport and communication facilities, etc. Economic viability. It essentially involves compilation of demand for domestic and export market, installed capacity of machines, market share, revenue expected, and suitable price structure. So economic viability, it essentially involves compilation of demand for domestic and export market, installed capacity of machines, market share, revenue expected, and suitable price structure. Economic viability. Financial viability, it should cover the aspects like non-recurring costs such as land and building, plant and machinery, etc. Recurring costs like wages, salaries and overhead, etc. Probable cost of production. Last, profit on expected sales. So financial viability should cover the aspects like non-recurring costs such as land and building, plant and machinery, recurring expenses like wages, salary and overhead, etc. Probable cost of production, and last, the profit on expected sales. Managerial competency. Entrepreneur has to include the mechanism for managing the venture in the project report. In case of small sized business, the owner or partners may take care of managerial activity, while a team of managerial personnel is to be brought in for managing various managerial positions across different levels of management in the case of corporate form of organization. So managerial competency, manager, the one who manage. Entrepreneur has to include the mechanism for managing the venture. So in his business mechanism, he has to include a concept mechanism, that is managing. If it is a small sized business, the owner are the partners, they themselves will act as a manager and they will manage the business activities. But if it is a large size business, then what have to do? A team of managerial personnel is to be brought in for managing various managerial positions across different levels of management if it is in the corporate form of organization. Provisional registration certificate. Entrepreneur has to apply for provisional registration certificate. It will be issued to entrepreneur after the fulfillment of certain conditions for a period of 1 year, subject to renewal of 2 periods of 6 months duration. So provisional registration certificate. So every entrepreneur has to apply for this certificate. It will be issued to them after the fulfillment of certain conditions for a period of 1 year, subject to renewal of 2 periods of 6 month duration. Permanent registration certificate. Once the business has commenced production or when it is ready to commence production, it is eligible to get the permanent registration certificate. So permanent registration certificate will be issued by the government to the entrepreneurs only when the business has commenced production, that is they have already started the industry and the production started, or if it is about to start, then the government will issue the permanent registration certificate. Statutory license. Entrepreneur has to obtain municipal license from the authority concerned. Then the entrepreneur has to register the unit with the central and the sales tax department. So all the entrepreneur has to obtain municipal license from the authority concerned. Then the entrepreneur has to register that license with the central as well as sales tax department. Power connection. Entrepreneur has to make application to assistant divisional engineer of state electricity board for power connection after paying security deposit and fulfilling the official formalities prescribed. So power is essential to set up the industry. So the entrepreneur has to make application to whom? To assistant divisional engineer of state electricity board to get the power supply after paying security deposit and fulfilling the all the other official formalities. Arrangement of finance. Entrepreneur requires two types of finance, namely long term and short term. While long term requirements are needed for acquiring fixed asset, short term requirements are meant for meeting working capital needs. So entrepreneur, each and every entrepreneur requires two types of finance. One is long term, another one is short term. Long term requirements are needed for acquiring fixed asset. Short term requirements are meant for meeting the working capital needs. Yes, we have come to the end of the lesson. So far we have seen the various schemes that has been introduced by the Government of India in order to uplift the various entrepreneurs, who will thereby lead to the development of India. I hope you have understood all the concepts in detail and clearly. Thank you, students.